Thank you very much. It was beautiful. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Tracey Porst, and I have the privilege of being the CEO of Karuna Hospice Services. On behalf of everybody from Karuna, thank you for joining us this evening for our 2023 memorial service. I'd like to begin the evening's proceedings by acknowledging the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples as the first Australians. We recognise their cultures, histories and diversity and their deep connections to land, water and seas of Queensland and Torres Strait. We pay our respects to the Yagawa and Turrbal elders past, present and emerging. Our memorial service is intended to offer a meaningful and respectful occasion for you as the family and friends of those who were cared for by Karuna's dedicated team of nurses, doctors and family support coordinators over the past 12 months and indeed the past 30 years. A team whose dedication to service I'm always proud of. And I'm sure those of you who have experienced our service know how special those people are. So this evening we come together to remember and celebrate a life, perhaps offer some closure and some healing, as well as offer our support and connection should you need us. We consider it a privilege to have been entrusted with the care of your loved one and that we value your continued connection. This evening you'll hear from Caroline Kerr, our clinical nurse consultant, Fiona MacAnally, our philanthropy manager, and Gracelyn Chipperfield representing her family. As the saying goes, it takes a village, and this event is a collaboration from all of the team here at Karuna. There's been some people here since very early this morning, so it's wonderful to see everybody here this evening. But I think a special mention is deserving for the organising committee of the event, including Linda, Verena, Tsultrim, Caroline, Sophie, Shannon and Preshni. So I now welcome Karuna Spiritual Care Practitioner, Venerable Tsultrim, to offer an intention for this evening, a dedication prayer and later some closing remarks. Thank you.
Hello everyone, thank you very much for coming. Hope I can read this okay. Okay, so life and death are not opposites, they walk hand in hand. It's not possible to have one without the other. And although death may bring a great sense of loss, feelings of knowing how one might continue to exist without the other, and a sadness that at times can feel totally overwhelming, there is not a human or any other living thing that will not have the experience of death. So you are not alone in that experience. Death and grief can in fact assist us to live our lives fully, because whether in life or in death or in our grief, it is love that will be our nourishment. Our love for the one who has died and the love we received from them remains in our hearts and minds for eternity, never diminishing, providing the gift that we can then share with others. Love is all enduring. It is the most amazing energy that goes beyond fear. It supports our sadness. Its power gives us strength and courage. And it is infinitely accessible in our hearts. In love, there is never any separation. In love, we can rest our weary body and mind in any moment on any day. Love offers us the grace to move through life until we too reach that inevitable yet unpredictable moment of our own death. Therefore, may we not be afraid. May we always remember the joy, and may we unceasingly find love in our hearts, and in that, the freedom and will to share it with others. And now I'd like to welcome Caroline Kerr. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Caroline, and I'm the clinical nurse consultant here at Karuna, and I lead a magnificent team of clinical nurses, and we work closely with Dr. Wendy, our medical officer, and we also work very closely with the family support team, which includes Tsultrim And at the moment, we've got trees out and we're soon to have a new staff member start, which is exciting. So thank you for joining us here at the annual Karuna Hospice Memorial Service. It provides us with a chance to reconnect with you, the families, and for us to pay tribute to the patients we've cared for and looked after for their past years. It was a privilege caring for your loved one, and we hope the service offers a time of peace and healing. The team here at Karuna is a special group of people who have a passion for providing palliative care and end-of-life care. They strive to provide the best care to support all, and that includes you as the family members and friends. As I said, it's been an absolute privilege being invited into your homes and at such a vulnerable, raw time. We were welcomed with open arms and often felt part of the family. I've just got a little poem here. In our hearts, we thought of you today, but that's nothing new. We thought about you yesterday and the days before that too. We think of you in silence. We often say your name. Now all we have are memories and your picture in a frame. Your memory is our keepsake with which we'll never part. Remember, you're always in our hearts. Thank you for trusting us. Thank you for supporting us. And, you know, just thank you.
Good evening, everybody. My name's Fiona MacAnally. I'm the philanthropy manager here at Karuna. And along with my incredible, amazing team, who you would have met coming in at the table this evening, Shannon and Sabrina, we are the lucky ones that get to work with our community to drive our fundraising efforts to ensure that we can raise funds and get community support to support the work that our incredible frontline staff do to help our families, our patients and their families. So we feel very blessed to be able to do that for Karuna and for people like yourselves. I'd also like to honour our donors that are here this evening. Philanthropy is, they really, really show that so much. And philanthropy being the love of humankind. And when I look at our supporters and our donors, they just are the most amazing people that support us year on year on year. And I just want to take that opportunity to thank them from the bottom of our hearts, from everybody here at Karuna. So thank you for that. I'd also like to pay respect to our other supporters and our community for the incredible work that they do to support our efforts as well. And without them, we just couldn't do what we do. So thank you to them. Before I leave the stage here, I'd like to share a poem with you. When I read this poem, it really spoke to my heart. I'm actually someone who's also had loss in my life. I lost both my mother and father at quite a young age. And when I read this poem, I could really hear my mother speaking to me. So I'd like to share that with you. It's titled The Fallen Limb. I too have lost family. And when I read this, a limb has fallen from the family tree. I keep hearing a voice that says, grieve not for me. Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I lived while I was strong. Continue my heritage, I'm counting on you. Keep smiling and surely the sun will shine through. My mind is at ease, my soul is at rest. Remembering all, how I truly was blessed. Continue traditions, no matter how small. Go on with your life, don't worry about falls. I miss you all dearly, so keep up your chin until the day comes we're together again. Thank you.
I'd like to introduce Gracelyn. She was married to Paul, one of our patients, and she's kindly agreed to share her story. So please welcome Gracelyn.
Good evening. I just want to say, firstly, it's such an honour to have been invited here this evening. And when I look around, it just has such a magical feeling about it. And just like when I first met the staff from Karuna, it's no surprise that this is where they're based. I think it rubs off onto them. Anyway, I'll get on with my story. So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I know I'm not the only one here this evening to experience loss. My heart goes out to all of you that have. This is a small clip of mine and Paul's journey. Paul had a unique quality about him. He never worried too much about anything, which made up for me, because I worry about everything. He was always happy, very grounded, intelligent, funny, and had a gorgeous smile. He was also very modest. He was a beautiful father to his two children, Emma and David, and adored his grandson, Noah. Paul was born in England and still had his lovely English accent. Having a science degree and his interest in medicine always led him to pharmaceutical positions here in Australia and England. He was the state manager for Queensland at Servier Laboratories for the last 30 years of his working life. He was loved by all who knew him. Paul and I had been together for 25 years and married for 17 of those. I always said we never did anything in a hurry. At the end of September last year, Paul was diagnosed with lung cancer. He hadn't been well for a few months and had lost 7 kilos, but we were still shocked. He was immediately hospitalised. Before he went to hospital, Paul and I made a pact. We would stay positive, treat the cancer, and take it one day at a time. And so we did. The specialist told us it wasn't good. I never asked how bad, so therefore they never gave us a time. Looking back, I'm pleased about this, because the false sense of security I was under gave me hope. The next 4.5 months saw Paul undergo intense chemotherapy and radiation. This led to him not being able to swallow. Therefore, he lost more weight and was on oxygen. At the time, I felt communication between the specialists themselves and their communication with us was very poor. Looking back, I still feel the same. After 4.5 months, the chemo specialist felt he could no longer continue with the treatment, and as Paul was too weak and he would be fighting a losing battle. We were very disappointed, to say the least. The specialist told us Paul had 2 weeks to 2 months. He recommended we get in touch with Karuna. And so we did. Nurses from Karuna came out to our home and they put a weekly plan in place. This was the only time we dealt with people who had excellent communication skills. On their first visit, we sat in our outdoor area. The nurse from Karuna, myself, Emma and David, and a friend, Jane. Paul made it quite clear to us that he did not want to be a burden on anyone. He wanted a peaceful passing. He didn't want to go back to hospital anymore. I promised him he would always be home. The next 8 weeks saw Paul's health decline slowly. He was on a mission to leave everything in order, making sure I would be financially okay, leaving notes to himself who we had to call. I found this heartbreaking. And when I mentioned it to him, he said it warmed his heart knowing I was going to be okay. One of the hardest things for me was facing the fact that Paul was going to pass. I struggled with this, but kept making the healthy juices and trying to get him to eat. He was my rock. I thought he'd live forever. Well, sort of. I was afraid, and I was afraid for him. He was so brave and courageous, often thinking about me and his children rather than himself. Each night we would have our time together, and I got to tell him many times that I loved him and that I loved our life together. I could only do one day at a time. Having Karuna come once a week was a blessing for me. They understood the situation, making sure Paul's pain levels were at a minimal and always revising his meds. On the morning of the 7th of April this year, Paul said to me, "I'm ready to go, darling. Are you okay with that?" I can't remember what I said to him. In fact, I can't remember the last thing I ever said to him. I called Karuna and they came over and started administering Paul's pain relief. The next morning at 6:10 a.m. on the 8th of April this year, my darling husband passed away peacefully. Myself, our dog Tonka, Emma and David were by his side. Paul had a beautiful celebration of life service at the Pullenvale Hall. There were over 200 family and friends. I have many happy, happy memories of my life with Paul. We did everything together. I will miss him every day for the rest of my life, and I will love him forever. I'm nearly finished. Sorry. The grieving process is something else. It's wicked and it's brutal. I am blessed having a beautiful family and great friends. I also feel Paul's love and his strength. I take great comfort knowing that Paul had a dignified and peaceful passing. I will always remember the humility and compassion the staff from Karuna showed. I will be grateful for that forever. Thank you so much, Karuna. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, Gracelyn. Now is the ceremony component of our memorial this evening. You're welcome to go down to the stupa, and we have some electric candles that you can just turn on underneath. And if you would like to put one of those onto the stupa in memory of your loved one, and then the heart with your loved one's name, you're then welcome to go and hang that on our wall of hearts that we are accumulating as the years progress. And then we will come back and we'll turn the lotus candles on, and then I'll recite the names of those who've died over the last 12 months. Okay, so now we're going to, as part of this ceremony, to just recite the names of those who've died over the last 12 months, those who were patients of Karuna. So this is in memory of Patricia, David, Graham, Kellyanne, Kamla, Michael, Robert, John, Graham, Paul, Norman, Amadio, Kerry, Dorothy, Beatrice, Sylvia, Barry, Alan, Eileen, Megan, Noni, Christine, Terence, Noreen, Zane, Kay, David, Judith, Danielle, Maureen, Winifred, Colin, Wendy, Valda, Douglas, Amy, June, Robert, Valerie, Linda, Shona, Alan, Robin, Rajama, Dung, Patricia, Aidan, Chris, Michelle, Harvey, John, Michael, Royce, Caleb, Spencer, Esme, John, Helen, Carolyn, Charles, Philip, Peter, Selena, Annie, Peter, Martin, Brad, Robin, Elizabeth, Will, Barbara, Jacqueline, Danny, Ian, Bill, Ray, Neville, Gary, Colin, Peter, Christine, Layton, Barbara, Margaret, Michael, Olive, Michael, Elvie, Anne, Beauty, Laurel, Toby, Werner, Robert, Lou, Erica, Margaret, Maria, Graham, Desley, Jennifer, Valda, Lex, Evelyn, Jeffrey, Jennifer, Michael, Joanna, Tina, Peter, Nola, Michelle, Francisco, Rita, John, Deb, Lynn, Claire, Anthony, Hari, Desmond, Jennifer, Suzanne, Mavis, Max, Helen, Mark, Derek, Francis, Chantel, Marie, Dennis, Tony, Eric, Ray, Katrina, and Gail. Let's just take a moment to remember them. May we always share a constant stream of love and harmony, flowing rapidly in all directions, touching all beings. May loving kindness, compassion, and wisdom be born in the mind streams of all beings everywhere, and may contentment prevail on earth and throughout the universe. May all beings be peaceful. May all beings be happy. May all beings be free of suffering. May all beings be safe. And may all beings awaken to the light of their true nature as quickly as possible. Thank you very much for coming, everybody. We have some refreshments, so please feel free to stay and mingle for a little while. And we wish you all the very, very best. Please take care of yourselves. Most importantly, just keep sharing the love. Thank you. Thank you.